walked down to the turf as a student body that wanted to be heard.
My sport was moved to March, like before anyone else's, which is football. So I kind of just took that and soaked it up a little bit. I'm mostly here for all the other sports that still could have happened. And I know that these kids have been working their whole entire lives for this moment, and for it to just get canceled like that, even though we have permission to play, I think it's kind of unreasonable.
They've been cooped up since March. They need that outlet. They need something for, you know, it's been very frustrating for not just parents. I think we forget that our kids have emotions and feelings as well. And it's been their whole world's been turned upside down.
When I did cheerleading and everything, it was kind of like my way of letting go of things when I was having a bad day. Like, that's where I went and I let everything out. And especially being the only Section 3 school not being allowed to play sports is really disappointing. And I know it's a big deal for a lot of these students, and they shouldn't be missing out, especially on their senior year.
And forget that also a lot of these kids use athletics to maintain a certain grade point average. They have to get good grades in order to participate in sports. It gives them incentive to do well in school. You take that away, and some of these kids are going to falter.
We actually have a meeting with our principal, Ms. Parkhurst, and our superintendent. About a few of the student representatives are going to go meet with them, talk about how we can fix it and change everything.
If other schools have set plans for the virus and how to contain it while still playing sports, I feel like there's no need to cancel Fulton sports when other districts are doing the same.